Muziek is een grote passie en liefde. De roots liggen in Gelderland of ze hebben hier een plek gevonden. 8 muzikale toppers zijn deze zomer te zien bij TV Gelderland. 8 weken lang Rockin' Gelderland. Vandaag met John Hayes.
Ik geloof niet dat ik Nederlands zal
leren.
Nou, dat zal wel meevallen. Zeg John, als je nou later groot bent, hè?
Yes.
Wat wil je dan worden?
Oh, hey.
Een groot, beroemd gitarist. De beste in Nederland. Ja, ik wil dit één dag, als ik de laatste 10 jaar van mijn leven, ik wil ook een priest of zo. Sign a protected preacher, you know, not as a priest, but a preacher like, yeah, it's gonna be all right, baby. We're gonna all go to heaven, you know, everything's gonna be good. Everybody's gonna go to heaven. It's open for everybody, no matter what you do.
All right, fellas, here we are at Madison Square Garden.
Teal Square Garden.
Man.
Ready to rock, man.
My spirit is fun. I think fun is my spirit. If I can say if there's anything in life that makes life worth living, it's having fun. And if you don't have fun, then you ain't living life, in my opinion.
Hoe ben jij hier terecht gekomen in Nederland?
Dat zeg je? Hoe?
Ja, how did you end up in Holland?
Ja, ja. I came over for the first time to play at Providing's Pop in Harlem with Mother's Finest. And that was on May 5th, 1990. Great, man, you know, everybody was smoking, you know, I walked through the crowd and people were rolling joints and I was like, wow, just like what I heard, you know, about in Holland. And of course, that's one of the first things you notice as an American, you really get off on that. You say, man, people can smoke over here. And but it's also, I noticed that the cultural mix of people was incredible, man. You know, in America, you know, you sometimes get kind of like black people, you got white people. But when I came here, it was every shade and color and mixture of people that you can imagine, you know. And I thought that was really beautiful, something different. All I do is think about you, baby, girl. I want to love.
Waarom ben je gebleven of ben je teruggekomen?
Well, you know, I met this beautiful girl, man, with a, you know, nice, tall, beautiful, wonderful woman named Olga. I just kept coming back to see her, man. And now we got 2 kids and everything, and I'm still here. I guess I'm gonna be here for a while now.
Yeah.
There's no way I can go back. The kids won't let me.
Dus je moet nog beter Nederlands leren.
Je moet beter Nederlands leren. Maar elke dag is anders en ik zal elke dag proberen met mijn Nederlands. Maar ik weet het zeker dat ik kan veel meer Nederlands dan de meeste Amerikanen kan praten. So, als een Amerikaner, ik ben niet zo slecht in mijn Nederlands.
Is Olga al een beetje trots op jouw Nederlands?
Yeah, she loves me. So anything I do is okay. She loves me so. She, baby, you are very good at that. Even though it's shit. You know, she says it's great. That's love, man. This is my stuff. And I'm gonna take it all the way with me. Good morning, world. How you doing? Here we are at the station. Ooh, waiting for the sun to rise, waiting to open up our eyes. Man, waiting on the train. Is that the train? No, it's just the wind and the leaves. Today's destination is Atlanta, Georgia.
Catch you that train, baby.
See you. All right, here we go. The adventure begins.
It's really like a dream come true, man. It's a treat, you know? Because, yeah, it's nothing like, you know, leaving home and going on an adventure. So I look at it like an adventure. You know, I never think of being on the road as anything shitty or, really, I feel lucky to be able to do it. And a lot of people would also feel lucky to do this too. So I don't want to make it sound like it's some kind of torture when it's really a lot of fun.
You make this trip like 10 times a year?
Yeah, 7 to 10 times a year. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And I think it's real nice to do that. But it also makes my world big. You know, I don't feel like I'm in one small world. And then, you know, I get a call to go on the road with Mother's Finest. Well, then I fly straight to Atlanta, and we're playing Atlanta, Washington, D.C., big cities in America. So I do get the best of both worlds, but I don't miss anything, no matter where I am. I've always lived on the road, so I always adjust to being wherever I am, as long as I got a bed to sleep in and some food to eat, you know, and that kind of thing. Then home is where you make it. But I like the big cities. It's nothing special. I mean, I live in L.A., I've lived in Atlanta, and I live in Druton, too, and it's all fine, man. You make your day. All right, man, here we are back in Atlanta one more time. It's a nice feeling to come back and see these highways, the same familiar highways coming from the airport leading into the city. I think I lived here for about 16 years, man. And it's one of my favorite cities in the world. I just like everything about Atlanta.
What is it about Atlanta?
It's the vibe, man. It's a southern vibe, you know. I think it's the mixture of people, too, man. You know, you got the nice mixture of all the races here in Atlanta, which I really like a lot. It's a crappy day, man.
Does this feel like home?
Yeah, it feels like home, man. It is home. I mean, I can drive these streets blindfolded. And, yeah, of course, I love Holland and everything, too. It's my second home or my other home. But this is my other home, too, you know. Hey, man, how you doing? In the 70s, these streets would be packed with people. There were thousands of clubs, you know, in the Atlanta scene. All had bands and live music. And these streets here would be packed with hippies, you know, people selling marijuana, selling pot on the street. Hey, man, you want an ounce of pot, you know, or you want a joint, you know, all be up and down the street. And those were like the really rock and roll days of America, man. It's sort of cleaned it up a lot.
Long gone.
Long gone. It's a pity, too. I wish it would come back now. Junk Man's Daughter. Coolest freaky clothes you can buy. Loud Nine. This is one of my friends from Atlanta. It's always good to be back in Atlanta.
Yeah, always good to be back.
It's always good to
always
be back.
Always good to be back.
And I'm,
Atlanta,
that's where we're at.
Atlanta,
yeah.
Yeah.
Cool.
Start thinking about something to sing about. And think of any subject. Woke up this morning and I had some fun. Me and the guys got together and wumbled. We decided we'd go do some rehearsing, work on some new material. And Angelo came by and put us on the TV. Yeah. Yeah.
When when you can be different than the other people around you, or be different, set yourself different, make your music different, be different than what you hear average on the radio. If you see guys that are acting like rock stars, don't just act like a rock star. Some people think if you go on stage and drink Jack Daniels and smoke cigarettes and look cool, like Guns N' Roses, then you're cool. That doesn't make you cool. What being cool is doing something different than that, you know, doing something that you know is what you do, that other people can't imitate what you do. And you gotta be the first one to do it. You gotta be original. And if you play a Jimi Hendrix song, you're only gonna sound like a guy playing a Jimi Hendrix song. You're not sound like Jimi Hendrix. So you might as well just leave that alone and find your own, don't go there, man. Find your own thing that you can do best. And that's all I do with my music. I'm not, say, like a Steve Vai guitar player, or I'm not a blues guitar player, but I find what I can do best and make my songs around that. I can write songs, simple songs, and come up with good hooks. And I can go up to the microphone with a guitar and sing them myself, and it's original. And it's got a certain kind of soulfulness, and people like it. So to hear that sound, you can only come to my shows or get my CDs to hear that sound. We're in Detmold, Germany at the studio, my favorite studio here at the Eric Tonehaus Music Institute. And yeah, we're just laying down some new tracks, man. We've been writing a bunch of new tracks. It's our favorite thing to do. That's cool. We set two voices together as I echo. Excellent. Leave it like that, man. I like this better. I like that better with just a few crossed voices. That's killer. Leave it like that, dude, please. That's great, man. Sound like a little conversation going on between some people. You know, like everybody sitting in a room smoking and talking together. That's perfect, man. So we just laid the songs down, you know, very quick and efficiently. And that was with Ramon and Pepper. But they're not here right now because they've finished the drum and bass track, so they've already gone on back. And so now I'm doing the final parts of putting on the guitar tracks, doing the vocal tracks.
Yeah, 1, 2.
I do, let's try again.
All right, now it's there, baby, I feel, yeah, it's cool.
When you feel you need a lift, just give yourself a special gift. The joy of being free is the greatest gift indeed, yeah.
All right, then
that was cool.
Yeah, we need to redo the pulling because the P was with too much air, so it's got a popping noise.
I'm no Pavarotti, man.
I love the dude. I listen to him all the time, though. I worship him.
Thinking about that magic jet, taking you around to where you was at.
One more time.
Thinking about that magic jet, taking you home to where you was at. Pulling on that power switch, fun and sunny days in that quick.
Yeah, nasty.
That's
it?
That's
cool.
That's it, killing, man. Cool.
Next verse,
ready.
All right.
While you're here for 3 days, do you think much about home, old guy, the kids?
Yeah, I do. And it gives me motivation. They're also very lucky
that they allow me to come do this. You know, a lot of times, guys, if they're in a certain situation at home, they don't have the freedom to come do the kind of things I do. So when I'm here, then that reminds me that I gotta be very productive when I'm here, because I gotta make good songs, because the kids love my songs, and when I get home, they gotta have something they want to do. Like, what'd you do, Daddy? Did you make some more good songs? I said, let's hear it. You know, they're gonna want to hear it first, man. So I gotta come home with the goods, you know?
And dream about getting some sleep. Fun on sunny days. Fun on sunny days. Real things don't matter. Don't worry about getting fatter.
Yeah, John the Voice Hayes.
All right, baby. We're done, right?
Yep.
Finished it.
You did it again.
Give me five, brother.
Man, that's truly hard work, especially if you're not a singer. Isn't that right, Corny?
So what
especially being a singer, it's really hard. I am a vocal person. I'm somebody that can do vocals. No, I'm not a trained singer. Yeah, I have never considered myself having some sort of great singing ability, but I do what I can do best. I don't go beyond my ability.
You can let your body roll. Everybody wake up, shake up, break up. When you catch me falling, this is how we make up. All the time we take up, when you really rolling, never gonna wake up till you shake up. Everybody wake up.
It's the big night, y'all. 2006 is about to be over with. We're gonna restart 2007. Welcome to the show.
Good show, John.
Merry Christmas.
Ready.
Party, y'all.
Kids love my CDs the best of any band. You know, they love Mother's Finest. They say, Daddy, put on Mother's Finest. And when I go, Daddy, put on Daddy's music. You know, and I'm really proud of that. They love my music. And I think they feel it. They feel the messages that I'm talking about to them. And even a few of the songs I write about them, you know, because it's like they always, kids always went around going, nay, nay, no, nay. And so I wrote a song called Yes, Yes, Yes. And I was like, you got to say yes, yes, yes. This is the best.
Yes, 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 the best you're going to get. Some news for you, man. Guess you should know. The memories of old friends lost in the end. You just know somehow in the game of life, nobody wins.
Yes, so I got him singing. Now, when the song comes on, yes, 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 this is the best. So, hey, it works, man.
You so can, there's some influence there. Huh?
Yeah, there's therapy everywhere.
They got to be good citizens.
They should be. You know, it's always true. If your parents are crazy, the child is going to be normal. If the parents are normal and work at a bank, the child's going to be crazy and an evil devil. So I think these kids are going to be priests, too. They're going to go to the church and be really banker, priests, lawyer, doctor kids.
There's a lot of little things in this one, too. There's little rap phrases and everything. You'll see. It's going to be good.
Okay. All right.
Who's to blame for playing this crazy game? So
let's bring back the good times.
start a party up.
Everybody, blowing everybody up. Don't be afraid.
That was pretty dope.
This was the best we ever had.
You think it's cool?
I think it's cool.
I think it's cool too.
I don't like to write songs like "I miss you, baby," "I love you," "I'm so lonely without you." I think you can do better than that. As a musician, you could write, as like I say, like a good song. Let's bring back the good times.
Do your party. Somebody start a party.
You know, and then it's just right in their face. A lot of people can't handle that, but I think it's the best thing you can do. Say it directly. Don't say it dirty. Say it clean. But say what you mean, but let it have a good side.
Let's bring back some good times. 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 Let's bring back the good times.
I think that's killer.
Yeah, I don't know.
Want to try one octave higher?
Yeah, I just want to try that. Let's bring back some good times.
Waar gaat dit over?
Het gaat over de Renault, mijn nieuwe Renault Traffic. Het is een leuke bus, een soort camper. Als je bent een muzikant, is het heel belangrijk dat je moet een van of een bestelwagen, een bestelauto hebben. Dus ja, het is perfect. Je moet veel ruim. Je hebt zoveel spulletjes, versterkers en alles. Ja.
En nou vannacht alleen naar huis, is dat niet eenzaam?
Nee, niet zo eenzaam. Nee, ik vind het leuk. Ik vind het heel leuk als je rijdt op de nacht. De nacht rijden is voor mij perfect. De sterren, de maan, en je bent bijna alleen op de snelweg. Het is perfect.
Are you ready?
No, no.
Come on.
No, no.
Real sweet.
Nah, nah, nah.
Man, our music makes people happy. People dance wherever we play. People dance, they go crazy.
When you're all alone. Nah, nah, nah. You can try like you lie, baby. Come on, fellas. Nah, nah, nah. You can roll like a stone, baby. When you're all alone. Nah, nah. But I'm gonna wrap you up
and
in my arms.
They party, but we also combine enough of the rock where they're like feeling the drive. They don't feel like, you know, they have to hold back. And I tell them, shout along, come on y'all, sing along, sing it. And they start singing, and they start dancing.
You can roll, you can roll, you can play, you can play, you can roll, you can roll, you can play, you can play, you can roll, you can play.
And at the end of the show, I feel almost like a preacher, like a priest or a preacher, and people are coming up, I really got your show uplifted me tonight. And that's what I said too, you know, sometimes I feel like half of what I do is between a guitarist and being a preacher, you know, try to make people feel good about their lives. Because I have the same problems too. I'm not like so happy and lucky all the time, but I have to deal with it in a way where I can stay productive and I can stay happy and laugh things off, but I still always want to inspire other people to feel kind of good, you know. I don't ever want to bring people down.
R.F. Dusseldorf, good night. Oh, you can play, you can play, you can roll, you can play, you can.
Done. Phew. We gave them everything.
We gave them everything. And then, but the good thing is they still want more, you know, and the thing is the audience is lucky with the kind of performance we give them. It's real pure and it's real blistering, you know. We're not really holding back, you know.
Yeah, look at these blisters.
But after 3 hours, you know, it's like, man, yeah, you know. That last song, my fingers like, god damn.
Definitely not these guys, but once the crowd gets going, he doesn't know the word stop, you know what I mean?
It's the fabulous Fox Theater. It's a beautiful theater. It's built for the premiere of Gone with the Wind. But this is the actual place where I first saw Herman Brode in The Wild Romance. They were opening for the Kinks in 1980. Man, they were so killer and kicked everybody's ass. And I bought a ticket to the next night show just to see Herman Brode. It was great, man.
So that was your first Dutch connection?
Well, I guess so, man. It's the first time I really
noticed some music from Holland. After I saw those guys open for the Kinks here at the Fox Theater, I ordered all the Herman Brode records I could find at the time from Holland. This is a place that used to be called Richards. This is an underground Atlanta. It's the first place I saw Mother's Finest in 1972. I was an instant fan. I was just a kid, man. I was a teenager. I saw him and I loved the band from that time, and I said to myself, boy, I sure would love to be in that band. And things worked out that way.
Mother's Finest rock. Happy New Year.
Hey, they were great. That was a great
They were
part.
So good.
Great.
We had a great time.
What was the best part?
I thought the
another
best
piece
part...
of the rock. The end.
No, I thought the best part was when they were like really saying, hey, Athens, we love you.
Oh, I know. That was good.
They were saying that.
We felt the love.
That was part number.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Thank you.
How do you look back on the concert?
I think it was cool. It was cool. The people were charged up. Everybody was excited. And I think it was a lot of fun.
Yeah.
I got a good vibe off of everybody there. And the band, really, I looked first at how the band felt. And as a band, we had a good time together. And that's one of the things. We do this a lot for our own pleasure. And if we don't have pleasure, then maybe it wasn't worth it. But, you know, between all of us and Mother's Finest, we really had a great time last night. We had a great gig.
Are you ready to go home, John?
Yeah, ready to go home, man. To be honest with you, it's been a real nice journey. It's been really satisfying. And time to pack up and head on back, man. Until the next time.
Yeah, that's already next week, huh?
It's already next week.
You I'll might as well have stayed.
Well, I got gigs with my own band. Next week, I'll be back here in America. It's just normal life, daily routine. It's better, couldn't find a better job anywhere.
I'm ready for a good day.
All right.
All right, man, here's the car.
Hey, Sly. Hey, buddy. How you doing, man?
Bye-bye train.
How about train? Hello, Daddy, right?
Yeah.
Gives you something to look forward to. It beats sitting around watching television, you know, wondering what you're going to do next. It sure does, man. I mean, especially if you're a musician, the most mind-killing thing could be like you're sitting around wondering, when am I going to get a chance to play again? When do I get another gig? The good fortune, and it's maybe our sad good fortune, but it's our own world we make for ourselves, is your schedule, when it's going good, your schedule is so full, you almost don't have time to rest. And that's when you know it's going good. And a lot of times you might take it for granted and say, oh, I need a break. But as soon as you take me and put me on a vacation or give me a break, in 5 minutes I'm bored. Well, I need something to do. You know, and that's just, so I got my own good therapy going when I'm that busy. And I realize it too. I'm well aware. You sometimes have to be your own best friend when you're on the road all the time. And when you're working in a band with people, it's a sort of a relationship, but nobody in the band is usually your best friend. You know, these are colleagues that you work with on a colleague level, but you still have to work together with the people, and you do want to be very social. But on the road, you have to be your own protection to keep yourself motivated.
Pretty cool, huh?
It was.
It was fat, man. You like our video, too, man. We had a video, man.
Angelo, my man, it's great that you were here tonight. And all the TV Held the Line viewers, thank you for watching this program and being here with us in the studio tonight. And we wish you a very nice night's sleep, a good night. And we're going to send all of our music and all of our best wishes out to you forever and always. Night-night. Bye-bye.
What the fuck? What the fuck?